The Movement for Social Justice believes that they are capable of gaining the support of more citizens in the next general election. So far, the MSJ isn't sure if they'll contest all 41 constituencies, but say they are receiving positive feedback from citizens across the country, even in the Prime Minister's constituency.
We have done a lot of work in Point 14 in the Deep South. We have done work in Arima, in Labre. We have been in Dago Martin constituencies. We have been doing stuff work in Labantil, in a number of the other constituencies along the East-West Corridor. We have people out in Sandy Grandy. There are people all over the country that have been calling on MSJ. In fact, we have been able to respond fast enough.
The MSJ leader says he doesn't see the party as just a third party in the political ring.
Because the PNM and the UNC are flip sides of the same coin. They are simply one supported primarily by persons of African descent and others by persons of Indian descent. But this, in terms of policies, in terms of running the system, they do exactly the same thing.
He says it is evident that people want a change.
We're not going into the election simply to put another name on the ballot, another symbol on the ballot. If this country does not have real change in 2020, think of where we will be in 2025.
As it pertains to financing for the party, Mr. Abdulah says many of their supporters have donated via their website.
We are the first party to have a website where you can actually donate online. And some people have already begun to donate online, small amounts, because as far as we're concerned, it's like the biblical story of feeding the multitudes, that you can in fact do wonders with relatively less money if we have good people in the communities who want to bring about that change.
Responding to the question of whether or not they had support from the labor movement, Mr. Abdulah says the MSJ has a very clear policy position that the labor movement would be pleased with. Nominations for positions within the party will be held on November 10th, and on November 19th, the party will hold its internal elections. The current leader, David Abdulah, will recontest his position.